Welcome to my channel. I'm glad you decided to join me today. We are going to take a look at what Americans eat too much, and today we're going to concentrate on cholesterol. Before that, let me introduce myself. I'm a board certified internist, cardiologist, electrophysiologist. The objectives for today: summarize the last video and then continue the series of what Americans eating too much, and today we're going to look at cholesterol, and is it all bad or not? And we'll end up, as always, with a quiz time. So we've been looking at the foods that Americans eat too much, and we've looked at saturated fats and trans fats. We've looked at the bad carbs, the added sugars, the high fructose corn syrup, and we addressed that on the last video. Essentially, there are good carbs and bad carbs and excellent carbs. Complex carbs are good. The refined carbs, the white bread, white pasta, white rice, the added sugars, the juices are not great for you. As an example, one orange has the 2 times the amount of fiber, the amount of sugars that you'll find on a glass of orange juice, for instance. So today we're going to concentrate on cholesterol. And regarding the cholesterol, we're going to look at the good, the bad, and the villain, and what can we do to decrease bad cholesterol in our body. And let's look at the top sources of cholesterol on the standard American diet. Again, eggs are on the top, chicken, beef, cheese, and pork, but again, eggs are on the top list, because each egg has about, the yolk has about 200 milligrams of cholesterol. Again, if you look at this, if you have 3 eggs, then you'll have 600 milligrams of cholesterol right here. So what about eggs? In addition to the cholesterol, eggs also have 5 grams of healthy fats, essentially mono and polyunsaturated fats, and they have proteins, and they have other vitamins and antioxidants. Nurses have studied, and the health professionals follow-up study found that if you have 1 egg a day, was not associated with increased risk of heart disease, although there was increased risk of cancer. But in diabetics, even 1 egg a day increased the risk of heart disease. But there is not a good correlation between the dietary cholesterol and the blood levels. However, there are people who are hyperabsorbers, where the amount of cholesterol that they eat is highly absorbed and have a significant impact on the cholesterol level. Regrettably, we don't have tests to measure who is a hyperabsorber or who is not. And again, processed meats are not good for you for many reasons. And processed meats in your diet actually contribute significantly to the amount of fats and cholesterol in your blood. And where the cholesterol come from, 80% or so is made by the liver. The liver can make all the cholesterol that the body needs. Only about 20% comes from the diet. And there are the different types of cholesterol. You're most familiar probably with the bad cholesterol called the LDL, the low density lipoprotein. And the good one is called HDL, high density lipoprotein. Essentially, is a scavenger and goes throughout the blood vessels and body and brings the bad cholesterol back to the liver. And there is no doubt type of cholesterol and the LDL cholesterol and other particles play a role in the buildup of plaques and atherosclerosis that later will lead to heart attacks and strokes, peripheral vascular disease. What is the issue with the cholesterol? It plays a crucial part on the development of plaque and atherosclerosis. And here is the beginning of the plaque on inside the artery, the endothelium, that over the years and the decade keeps getting bigger and bigger. At one point can rupture, cause a clot, and depending if it happens in the heart, will lead to a heart attack. If it happens in the brain, will lead to a stroke. If it happens in the leg, will lead to leg ischemia, potentially gangrene. This process starts very early on, and in fact, atherosclerosis a pediatric disease. You know, conclusions, the cholesterol is essentially for life and is a precursor of many hormones, including the sex hormones, different types of LDL particles. The most ones you're familiar with are the LDL called the bad and HDL, the good cholesterol. And according to the American Heart Association, there are 85 million Americans who have a cholesterol level of 200 or higher, and 28.5 million have it above 240. You should have a cholesterol screening test and discuss with your doctor where you stand regarding this important risk factor. And we do have many ways of lowering lipids, starting with, again, dietary changes and with the exercise, and if necessary, medication. And it's very important to realize that cholesterol is just part of the story on the atherosclerotic process, and there are many other risk factors that play a significant role, including inflammation and chronic inflammation. And the good news is the lifestyle medicine not only will lower your cholesterol, but also will lower your chronic inflammation. It's quiz time, so let's look at the previous question and which of the statements are correct. One egg has 200 milligrams of cholesterol. One egg has 100 milligrams of cholesterol. There is a perfect correlation between dietary cholesterol and blood cholesterol. Most of our body cholesterol comes from the food we eat. In fact, obviously, the right sentence is one egg has 200 milligrams of cholesterol. There is no correlation between dietary cholesterol and blood cholesterol. And again, most of the all cholesterol is made by the liver and not comes from the food sources. In the next video, we're gonna look at another quiz, and we'll answer this question on the next video. If you found some value in this video, please subscribe to my channel and write comments and ask questions. We're trying to make this as interactive as possible. And remember, your health is too important to be delegated to others. Let's just take control. See you next video.